It's hard to believe today is a week on from the fatal Loafers Lodge fire in Wellington. Since then, there's been an outpouring of support for the community, but the road to recovery, well, it's long. Jessica Swan is at the City Mission this morning to give us an update on the efforts. Morena, Jess.
Morena, Jenny May. You're right, there has been an outpouring of support, and a large part of that has been the City Mission's work. Thank you for being with me, Murray. Tell me, how many people are you serving since those impacted by the fire?
We've got about 80 people we're working with and have been working with over the last week.
And the kind of money and support you're getting in to help them?
So the public have been amazing. We've had, as at last night, we've had $230,000 worth of donations, plus of course the $50,000 from council. So $280,000 to spend on the needs of the people who have been impacted by the fire.
And this table is a picture of some of that, right? Donated goods, funded goods as well?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, it just reflects what people need right at the moment and what the public and the council are helping us to do.
Yeah, you talk about that need, but obviously that's going to change over time. Tell me through the phases of support you're going through.
So if we think back a week ago, the initial requirement was for food, was for clothes, was for cell phones, and to get people into temporary accommodation. And alongside the government agencies and council, that and you know, other community agencies, that was able to happen. The second phase was later last week, which was giving people some cash, some ability to continue on with their lives. We're now probably into the third phase where we're still doing cash distribution to people that need it. We're distributing clothes, but we're also thinking about the things that are really important, like dentures. We're paying for dentures for people that lost them in the fire.
Wow.
Laptops for people that lost their equipment in the fire. We're also paying for people to come to funerals, because we know the first funeral is going to be this week. And for family to get here, sometimes they need help. Mm. And then there's a fourth phase, which is people now need to move into more permanent accommodation. There'll be costs associated with that, furniture, things that because of the regulations, government agencies can't necessarily pay for, and we're able to fill that gap. But long term, there's also lots of psychosocial support, lots of counselling for the trauma that people have faced.
Look, a lot of support already and a lot of support to come. Thank you for your time, Murray.
Thanks so much, Jess. It's good to hear what's happening down in Wellington for those who were impacted.